that is the online editor. And the great part of the online editor is that it's a 100% client side. Everything's running in the browser. So you have more or less infinite scale for us. So we have thousands of users, and this is even hosted on GitHub pages, our community version. And we are thinking about how we can have more robust service, I would say, in that way, without having to have a backend, because backend will open a new door for challenges, and especially on those use cases where we have such latency. And the first thing that I do is, like, I want to do a traffic violation, a demo. And the first node that I want to do is to create the current violation. I create input data for a violation. And for this input data, I create a new data type, okay? This new, I add a custom data type, and the data type will be called pviolation, and you'll be a structuring. And I will have two things on this data type. I will have the type of, sorry, the type that will be for now a string. This is the type of the violation. I will also have the speed limit of the road. Speed limit, I'm gonna make sure that that will be a number. And also the actual speed. Imagine that I'm using this to take in some radar, for instance. And then as soon as I have this data type, what I do next time, I go for my violation node. So I go for this violation input node, select here, and select the data type. Take a look on the input. As soon as selected data type, this is a constant evaluation. Now I have my form here to try my data type. This is pretty cool because I'm actually starting to see things live, okay? Now, the next thing that I love to do when I'm learning new stuff is to do a hello world, okay? So I will connect this data type with a decision, enter in the decision, and I do a literal expression. First, I will do, see, I'm starting to evaluate this decision as a null here, okay? So what I will do is do a drive a violation caps dot type and just print this. As soon as I type here, I start to see the live feedback there. This is cool, right? This for me changes the way that I personally approach DMN. For instance, if I go here and change my decision node for, let me put something here for speed limit, change the evaluation. And when I put something here, change the decision, let's put a value in the actual speed like 80. I change my decision node here to actual speed. And I have instantaneous feedback of what is going on.